Of course, as Canadians, one of the biggest topics of the last year has been the decline of the Canadian dollar versus the US dollar. And this is kind of an interesting time for Canadians. We wonder, are we the ugly duckling in the world? Reality is, it's the exact opposite. Globally, we know that the US dollar has appreciated quite dramatically, and it's not just against the Canadian dollar, but against major global currencies, the euro, the yen. Most of the currencies around the world, most industrial-based currencies, have really gotten impacted quite negatively. This is actually a major change that's happening. We're seeing currency markets move more than ever that we've seen in the past. Actually, these are some of the worst currency markets we've seen in many years, but this is actually very structured specifically because many of these economies are using their lower dollar to grow their economies or try to push for greater export growth in their economies. Now, the US economy has been growing, and I've been actually quite surprised by the resilience of the US economy in the face of the fact that their currency continues to appreciate. So that should theoretically have a negative impact on their export growth as from their economic growth perspective and could potentially hurt their economic growth long term. Now, when we look at this, what does it mean? We've had these major moves, moves that usually take 6-7 years, we've had happen in 6 months. And that really does make us question, where is it going from here? So given this, what does it mean for investors? First, I believe we're in the late innings of this currency move. We have seen such great volatility, but I don't think that it's sustainable. I don't see the US dollar continue to rise dramatically. Now, that doesn't mean it's not gonna, the Canadian dollar doesn't go to 74, 73, maybe even to 70 cents for a short period, but that's not a sustainable level. But as a Canadian investor, what we really need to understand, we've all benefited from this currency if you have had exposure to US dollar stocks and US investment funds that had this currency. Understand that benefit that you've had, and you probably want to take some of that risk off the table. You want to think about currency hedging. You know, there are a lot of investment funds that you can currency hedge that exposure out because I think you're probably on the right side of currency hedging than trying to ride this currency further. Second, you want to also understand, look at the funds you have and have they been masking their kind of probably weaker performance with currency performance. So they're telling you, oh, look at our great long-term returns, but is it just coming from currencies? Dig in and understand because that's not sustainable. That's not really good investment management. Really dig in as an investor and understand because it's probably a time to rebalance your portfolio for this.